Check 1, 2. Bitcoin to the moon. Check 1, 2. We're sending Bitcoin. We're sending Bitcoin to the moon. Sending Bitcoin to the moon. I'll say it again, we're sending Bitcoin to the moon. Hey, what is going on, everyone? It is Sunday night. Welcome to Dano Crypto. Smash up the like button. Smash the subscribe button. Hit the bell button. Hit all of the buttons. So, hope you guys are doing good. We are going to be diving into the markets tonight. Let me do my intro real quick. Welcome, everyone. Guys, gals, aliens, and degen freaks. Welcome to Dano Crypto. On this channel, I show you guys how to make simple, effective, and easy moves in the cryptocurrency ecosystem. Now, so, 319 subscribers. Thank you guys very much for supporting the channel. Thank you for leaving all the comments. Thank you especially to the guy who commented and said, your office is in a garage. And I was like, okay. And? I was like, why does it matter where my office is? I love this garage. this is a nice garage. I have freedom in this garage. In this garage, I will make six figures. In this garage. I gave the example, I was like, Alex Becker has his office, one of his offices at least, in his garage. So, I think he's doing all right. So, let's go into the Bitcoin rainbow chart. So, I love looking at this chart. It's one of my favorite charts. So, as you can see here, we are in accumulation phase. I mean, we're in just like buy phase right now. We're almost in the basically a fire sale phase. that would be in the really low ranges. But right now we are sitting below, we are sitting according to right now CoinGecko. I've been honestly wanting to go to CoinGecko more now because CoinMarketCap is getting kind of a bit flooded. I don't like their interface setup. They changed it. It's just now just a little too much going on, so it's kind of pushing me away. So we're looking at Bitcoin right here. It's at 26,655. So it was sitting at 26,900 as of this morning, and so now we are seeing the price moving down. So now it's at 2%. And we're just kind of seeing, yeah, we're seeing the bears win here on shorting the market. And we just have a lot of sell pressure on Bitcoin. And it's not a bad thing. It just means you're going to get nice cheap prices. This is definitely just accumulation phase. So if we look at the rainbow chart and we see here, we can see how high it can get. It can get anywhere up to $63,000. At the peak, we saw Bitcoin go as high as, if we look at the year, we saw Bitcoin go as high as, I think on our market read, I think it touched 69,000, almost 70,000. But that was like, I mean, it was only for like probably a brief second because it was just like, it was just peak euphoria. And people were like, oh, okay, we gotta sell. And then, you know, so then we went down. We had to go up again, and it went down. And then we started to go back up again, but then we had the FTX debacle. We had all the crazy things happen in the market. All the dominoes started to fall. And then that's when we saw, you know, now we're here. So we're gonna get into some other things in the market here. I think, first of all, I'd like to give a shout out to L Bank. L Bank, I have been liking this platform. Just it's super simple, and it's a good way to do no KYC. It has a lot of meme coins at launch. I think a lot of the meme coins and I would say not all just meme coins, but tokens that are trying to get off the ground go to places like LBank and MEXC. So if you guys want to use my referral code, if you just go to my channel and you can click on the LB Bank sign up, use my referral code, and you can start trading on there, and it's a fun platform. And just people were asking me questions on how to basically send in and out crypto out of your MetaMask or out of one of your wallets, and it's a really it's a question that can be you know, just a, it's not a dumb question. There's going to be a lot of people asking questions like this, and we can't be pretentious and not and say, oh, you don't know how to do that yet, because we're so early in the space, and we can't be we can't be down on people if they're just asking basic questions. So so I have tutorials, they're old videos, but I'm gonna start making tutorial videos on how to do this, because it's just, once mass adoption happens, there is going to need to be good education and good content on how to do this. So I answered a lot of these questions in the comments. I engage in every single comment that people have left me. I will heart it, I will like it, even if it's even if it's kind of trolling. You know, I'll take the troll comments all day. I have no problem with that, but mostly, you know, pretty much everything has been super positive. Everyone has been super nice. One of the live streams that I did, I had a lot of people come on and engage, and it was fun. So I'd love to keep that going. If you guys let me know in the comments what day you guys would like me to do live stream, like what are some of the days that you guys watch that, you know, watch live stream content, you know, times of the day. I'd love to know and get your feedback. So let's look at some other things in the market. If we go into CoinGecko and just look at the top, you know, just the top 20 here. We have Ethereum sitting at 1,798. We have Tether at 3. We got BNB at $300 and $305. XRP at 45 cents. We have Cardano at 35 cents. We have Lido staked ETH at the 8th spot. It's interesting. So, and then we have also Doge at 7 cents. We have Matic at 84 cents. I still think, I'm telling you guys, that's a buy right there. Not financial advice, but that's a good buy. Solana at $19 and 46 cents. That's cheap. That's a good buy too. You know, so the Solana ecosystem's not dead. You know, there's still a lot of NFTs trading on Solana. There's a lot of dApp platforms. There's still a lot of traction. I don't know, if you go to, go to DeFi Llama. If we go to the DeFi Llama and we look at Solana, search Solana. See, it is loading. It is loading. All right. So, did that pull up? Did that pull up? There we go. All right. So, on Solana. There it is, okay. All right, so we have Marinade Finance, we have Lido Stake, and we have Orca, SPL Governance, Radium, Solan, Serum, Atrix, Francium, Meteora. So, I mean, there's still traction. Sorry it took me so long, I had a brain fart there. I was trying to look and I was like, okay, yeah. So total value locked is $265 million. So that doesn't seem like a lot. So you know, if we were to go to, say, Ethereum, we were to look at Ethereum. Total value locked is 26.9 billion, and the top dApps that we have and protocols we have Aave, MakerDAO, Curve Finance, and LibdoDAO. And Uniswap, and those are obviously the top five. That's what moves. If we didn't have those active, Ethereum would not have the money movement that it has currently. So, you know, I've explained this a lot, or I haven't explained it a lot, but I have it before in other videos where, you know, if you have to want Ethereum to succeed. Because if it weren't for Ethereum, none of these other protocols and layer two solutions that are built off of Ethereum, EVM, besides the other protocols like that are like ICP and Hedera Hashgraph and all these different, you know, different types of blockchain technology that might not necessarily be EVM, they're their own thing. Those are different, but when I'm talking about the crypto ecosystem like DeFi, it runs on Ethereum. So you want Ethereum to succeed, and there's nothing wrong with that. So I think that's why there's so much value locked in Ethereum. People are staking their Ethereum. You know, they want, you know, the, and people think, you know, when that upgrade went into effect and they. There was a lot of speculation that Ethereum was going to dump on the upgrade. I think it was the Shanghai upgrade where you can unstake your ETH, and it was going to be like thousands and thousands of ETH that was going to be unstaked and dumped on the market. But really, I think people just like restaked it, just like took the rewards and then restaked it, because they know that it would be really dumb to sell it and dump it on the market on a bear market when we know Ethereum's going to go to 10 grand. So, I mean, are you with me? I know I'm speaking some knowledge here and truth, because the supply and demand and the price and everything correlate. So that's how we just have to look at things. I've been in the market long enough to now know that that's kind of what's happening. So, and the numbers don't lie. The numbers don't lie. 26 billion right there locked in. Lido DAO on five chains, and one of them being Ethereum. Also Solana. So something that in Twitter, I'll go to Twitter real quick, and in a comment, someone was, I think it might have been Borovic, let's see, where they said, you know, how much would you need to retire? Yeah, it was this one, here's this thread. This thread's cool, I think. Yeah, I know, it was Ash Crypto. Okay, so how much money is enough for you to retire completely and never work again in life? It's 100K, 500K, 1 million, 5 million or more. And I said, if you're smart, it can be only 100K. I'd invest a big portion into BTC and then have the rest of it spread out over every single DeFi protocol, gaining yield, and then staking all that yield. You'd be a multi-millionaire in no time doing that strategy. And that one got pretty good views. This one got almost 2,000 views. It's got 14 likes. I think a couple didn't have any retweets yet. But yeah, I think my example is pretty a pretty good example how you could really turn 100K into millions of dollars if you are doing a correct rinse and repeating, making sure you're not having any impermanent loss when it comes to staking, and you are having liquid staking, which is now possible, where you do liquid staking where you can actually take out the benefits and not have it be locked in to a certain amount where you have to wait, you know, 30 days or more. So that is something to think about there. So I hope you guys are enjoying this content, and if you haven't already, subscribe, hit the like button, smash the like button, leave a comment, and let's look at crypto bubbles, because I think the whole entire market is red here. So I see one right here, so let's just talk about it. Hex. I did the Hex bridge. So I went onto Pulse Chain and I have successfully used the bridge and bridged over my hex to Pulse Chain. So now I have hex on Pulse. So if I'm understanding everything correctly, is that when you have hex on Pulse, it might be worth more than hex on Ethereum. And why that may be is because if there is more trading and volume and worth supply and demand on hex on Pulse Chain, then there would be more liquidity there if there is less hex on Ethereum opposed to Pulse. Because for some reason, I think the prices are different. I might be understanding that wrong, but if there are any hexagons that are watching this video, I'll put a hex hashtag in this video, so then if any of you guys can correct me if I am wrong, please just let me know. But yeah, so I'm running into an issue here because I need more PLS. I need more Pulse to be able to actually use the Pulse X swap that is right here. So let's just go to the website. We'll go to Hex, and then we'll see if it has a let's go to Pulsechain.com, and then if we go to Pulse X here, I will show you guys. I will just connect my wallet here. I'll go back to my camera. I don't want you guys seeing anything. Haha. Okay, so I'm switching my network over to Pulse Chain. Everyone's been, well, not everyone, only, you know, just people who are interested in Hex and want to explore different ecosystems. I am in the Pulse Chain network, and as you can see, I have 0.07 Pulse. And I have 1,632 hex on Pulse. And so what I'm trying to do, because I need Pulse to be able to do a swap, just like you would with for gas, just like you would with Ethereum and other layer 2s. So I would like to swap some of my hex for maybe some Pulse, you know, PLSX, or maybe, you know, more Pulse. So I'm not able to do that. So that is the predicament I'm in here. So you see, I have that hex and I have not enough Pulse. So I'll show you, if I wanted to say do 800 of that, $22 worth swap, and I'd confirm that swap. And it says you do not have enough PLS, so I'm going to reject that. And so that is the predicament we're in there. So I need to be able to get more PLS. So any of you hexagons, how do I get more PLS? So I just, you know, I need to do more research. Now you're probably gonna tell me, do your own research. You know, hexagons are, you know, tough love. You know, they're gonna make you work. All right. I think that's all we can cover. You know, I need to actually work on my Bitcoin conference content, because I have a lot of phone content. I have some amazing stuff that I love to share with you guys. And thank you so much if you've watched this video all the way to the end. And thank you so much for sticking with me. And I guarantee you this, you will not be disappointed with the content and the information and just the good vibes that I want to bring you guys and to the crypto community. And I will say that, you know, going to the Bitcoin conference, it really showed me that, you know, you can really change your life in crypto if you just, one, believe in yourself, two, have a plan, and three, just be yourself. And I'm going to leave you with that. Peace, guys.